In my life, yeah, I've been doing shows every now and then. I've done it before, but a long time ago. But in recent times, I've never promoted a show and did not mention a musical artist or other comedians performing with me, and you all came out. That's love right there. And just to let you know, you guys are the reason why I do what I do. God bless you. Thank you for the support. I remain your very own Basketmouth. Love you.
You've seen the shows, you've seen the, you've gone online, you've seen YouTube, you've seen the videos, you've seen the whole the adverts and how Basketmouth already make this an epic event. All you have to do is be here, and if you're not here, you don't know what you're missing, but I'm sure you're going to play something for them to watch. Yeah.
I don't like using one perfume because I hate when people go like, that's a Tom Ford, right? I hate it. So they mix them up and they're confused. This is the second one. Yeah. Fourth one. The person who sniffed at it. What are you wearing? It's none of your business.
I enjoy it too, man.
I loved it. Like, I'm very critical of Nigerian shows, just generally, movies, you know, music, comedy, anything, because I think Nigerians can do better. And so I came here tonight thinking, what is it gonna happen? What's gonna happen? And I got here and I was pleasantly surprised. It started on time. The show went well. The format did well. Mike Aremu was great, and Basketball like pulled it out of the bag. Like, the comedy, the humor, the jokes were on point.
The jokes were fresh.
I think he's done so well, and
the way he executed it, we had so much energy. So I mean, that's with the timing of the DJ, it was absolutely fantastic. He knocked this one out of the park.
Did you hear that? Did you get that? Did you hear that?
First time, no joke. First time sold out.
He's the beast. He's a guru guru. Emperor. He's a guru guru one.
This is what I do for a living. I love it.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the journey to Basketmouth Uncensored. This is the tour. I'm sorry, I'm sounding a little bit down, or gloomy, or moody. I'm a little bit sick. I'm here. I just started having allergy and flashes. One second. Hello, Paro. This is my pig. Alba.
I'm okay. You guys are at the airport, right?
I know you guys have noticed, you know, this is a grimy tour. You understand? Normally tour, you're supposed to have a tour bus and, you know, all the crew and everything. See us. We wait for taxi. We use the train, we're going to the city. We're taking the train. So we just walk down and get into this. And that's my wife just. I brought my wife. That way, all them groupies won't bug my life. It's a better way not to get caught. Bring your wife along. This is how the real tour is supposed to be like, you know, enter the cold, you buy train tickets for the train so you can feed from the environment, not to end it. You know, all those tour buses for lazy comedians. You know, the hardcore comedians, you don't use tour buses, you use public transport. Because you have to feed from the environment so you can actually, since I'm entertaining these guys, I have to, you know, see what they see, do what they do, read the papers, smell their bad breath, train, body odor.
Airport road, my stake is basically climb. Government goes to the one where they fit.
what's up, guys? How you guys doing? Okay, I just woke up from sleep not too long ago. I've been tired. I went to Aberdeen, which was the first show. It was pretty nice. Got a little bit of flu right now and tension as well. Slept a little bit, woke up, and didn't realize where I was. It was that bad. Like, I was very, very tired. So I have to now start, you know, constructing my materials, you know. This is what I do. Like, this is what I do most times that I'm doing stand-up comedy. But when I'm handling a corporate event, it's less pressure. You guys will love it, trust me. You guys will love it. The show's going to be very good. It's going to be very good. God has been very supportive. Yeah. He's the one that keeps me going. I'll see you guys later. Back to my music. Oh, this one is nice. This one is nice. This is the kind of music you listen to when you are at Babish smoking weed. I'm not joking. Catch you guys. I'm gonna catch you guys when I'm getting ready. You understand? I'm gonna take you guys to the bathroom. You guys are gonna see me, see how I shower, you know, see everything, how I get ready for my show. Alright, you guys are gonna be seeing some X-rated shit right now. Alright? All the ladies get ready. It's bigger and blacker. You guys are in my area right now. You guys are invading my privacy. Cut this camera off, so I'm done.
I think Basketmouth is—he's a really good comedian. I'm quite impressed about the way he takes himself, like carries himself on stage, and he has an almost like really huge stage presence, which is amazing.
Looking at him alone is just funny enough. He doesn't even need to say anything.
Before he opens his mouth, that's it. He just starts laughing.
Basically, I hope he doesn't think I'm into lines. I'm a bit scared.
He's crazy good. Trust me. I can't wait for this shit to happen. He's really good.
He's an undiluted African comedian. Simple and straightforward.
Oh my god.
What's the
about? I love him.
He's number one for me.
Well, as a comedian, he's the best.
Oh, he's really funny, Anna. You should do this every year.
So. Me too.
He's a great comedian. I've always liked him right from the beginning. I'm a very big fan of him. And,
he's talented and I know he's going to do great things tonight. We're going to probably be really happy. You know, we've been working Monday to Friday and I believe with tonight is the time to relax and then laugh our ass out.
Well, yeah.
Hopefully.
We like Basketmouth. That's why we're here tonight. And it's especially great that we can do this on Valentine's night in Manchester.
My expectation is, you know, come here, get a feel of the Valentine's Day, you know, have a good laugh, and then have a good day.
I'm just looking for a casual night, something just to relax from my long day at work. Nothing more really.
We're expecting to, you know, laugh and keep on laughing after leaving here.
Yeah, and keep laughing till next week. The next week after that.
Yeah. I'm expecting to laugh so hard, I'll be on the floor. That's how funny I think this guy is.
Well, I am looking forward to the show, hoping to have a good night, and yeah, to laugh.
I know he's going to turn off the stage. I know he's going to kill the stage again. And I'm just looking forward to greatness, to be honest. I can't wait to meet him and, yeah, have a little chat with him as well.
I know it's going to be a sold-out show. It's already sold out. It's Basketmouth. As usual, London, Manchester, Birmingham, always sold out.
Expectations are like going to be like really great.
Hey. I'm ready now, yeah? I hope I'm ready.
Saw the flags, Japanese. No one will believe me. Ran back to the town.
The tension kicks in. I don't fear. I don't fear God. Okay.
Boys.
Go.
God, you watch it.
Just say, ladies and gentlemen. Just say, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome Basketmouth.
No, I'll go collect them.
No need to. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Basketmouth. By the way, that's my
brother.
Okay, I need to drink. coffee real quick.
Ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen.
Uno, biko, biale. Yeah, I'm about to go on stage right now. This is the beginning, first show of the UK tour. It's gonna be great. It's gonna be great. I'm gonna pray shortly without anybody watching. It's gonna be a good one. I think I came out really prepared. And I just pray that I'll be able to remember every joke that I wrote for this concert. Just in case you guys don't know, before every time I get on stage, there's a panic attack. Always, every time if I get on stage, I'm always scared because I always think that, okay, what if you bump? What if it's not good? Because I judge myself by my last performance. So far, so good. God has been very merciful, and I believe he's going to do it again tonight. I want to say a big thank you to GT Bank, GT Create. They came through. Thank you very much to Mrs. Lola, GD Sipe, the MD, thank you so much. Mr. Shego Agbaji, thank you very much. I'd like to say a big thank you as well to, you know, all the people that came out to support the show. You guys came out to watch just me perform. We didn't promote any musicians, we didn't promote anybody else. You guys actually came out to see me, and that's love right there. That's love right there. I really appreciate you guys. Thank you very much for the love. It's been 15 years, going to 16. I'm doing my thing. Without you guys, I wouldn't be doing what I do. You guys actually made me happy. You guys are the best. Thank you so much. I'd like to thank my crew, Dr. Tumaku, Kayode, Ariwayo, Ano Baseki. We all know her, Chichuwa. She changed her name. I don't know why. I'd like to thank Gunna Okwike, the runaway soldier. There's a lot of them. I've got a great, it's big Alan Louie, Onyade, that's Kenge. I'd like to thank, it's so many, my crew, Magnus, Umiri. These guys are the ones actually behind me. You might not know this. These guys are the ones that are really, you know, making things happen. And to my biggest critic, my wife, she doesn't lie to me. She tells me the joke is dry. She tells me.
So that, bro, I enjoyed my step here.
It was amazing. It was amazing.
It was really funny. I enjoyed myself. Night out.
Very funny guy.
Gave us what we wanted, what we paid for, so that's lovely.
And we're very proud. We represent Africa to the highest level.
Fabulous, so really nice. I enjoyed myself and my friends. We had fun.
It was good. Yeah, really good. For 2 hours, not easy.
It was wonderful. I really enjoyed it. And definitely I'll be back next time.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, definitely. Definitely come back.
Basketball is one of the media. Thanks.
Thank you.
Ah, trust me, I'm happy right now. I know you guys saw me when I was panicking. You know, but now, you know, what I standard, I always turn the fear to my strength. I always, you know, do the reverse approach to that, you know. And I love the crowd. The crowd was very responsive, very upbeat. The sense of humor was awesome. Love the crowd, you know. It's not just about my materials, it's actually the crowd. They really got me. Next up is Birmingham. I'm excited, the Sunshine City, yeah. Birmingham, I'm excited because it's a new place, new ground, you know, something fresh. You know, new audience, young people. I pray it gets sold out by tomorrow, because right now the flu is kicking my behind. Sweat down.
Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you very much. Thank you guys. Trust me, you guys are gonna have fun.
Trust me.
Alright, you guys are still hanging with me. I just finished the Manchester show, going straight to Birmingham. I'm confused right now. Going to Birmingham, where's the next stop? And yeah, this is how we roll. You know. We don't have a tour bus. This is our tour bus right here, the train. So far, so good. Everything is going well. And just in case most people don't know, this is my PA. Yeah. It's Christine. Christine, she runs all my business here in the UK. Why are you laughing?
Because I want to. You're just so funny. You make me laugh every time.
Every time, yeah. Thank you. She's one of my biggest fans. All right. So far, so good. Everything is well. I've got my whole crew, my manager right here. I've got that's my DJ right there. You know. It's strange, it's weird. I don't know her or her. I just met him. He's a cool guy. He went to school with a senator and this other guy. And this is the thief. That's Rockmore. Rockmore is the guy behind Cocoa Bar. This is us right here. There are more people at the back gossiping. That's what we do. So far, so good, you know. We don't have our own privacy. And you know, I'm sorry. Yeah, hope we're not invading your privacy or anything. So, have you heard of a comedian called Basketmouth? Never heard of a comedian called Basketmouth. He's one of the biggest comedians in Africa. You've not heard of him?
No.
Wow. What about? Have you heard of P Square? What about Two Face? No. All right. So I'm happy now because I'm Basketmouth. If you had told me that you know P Square and Two Face, I would have been upset. But since you don't know any of us, it's fine. It's fine. I'm very famous.
Okay.
Yeah. If you give me an autograph, I'll sign an autograph for you. Whenever you're free, I'll sign it. You're joking. Anyway, the show is tonight, Birmingham, and next stop is going to be the Indigo, the O2. Kill it, 100%. Right, I'm gonna catch you guys later. I have to start writing the materials because I have a lot to do. I missed some jokes last night. There were some materials I forgot. So I have to sit back and make sure that I get everything right because I have to do my straight 2 hours. No disruption, nothing missing. All right, catch you guys later, all right? Trust me, I will see a white girl that will love me. Trust me, before the end of this trip, no white girl, a white guy. She's my person, she doesn't count. I will try, we'll go on a trip and check if anyone knows me. So you've never heard of Basketmouth before?
No,
never.
You're
checking me out, you've seen it, right? I'm really famous, eh? I'm big, I'm the shit. Have you seen anything yet?
No.
Where are you from?
Me? Edinburgh,
Warrington. Originally, where are you from?
I'm from South America.
South America? Oh, okay. It explains why she doesn't know me. Alright. I'm gonna ask more people. Excuse me. Have you heard of a comedian called Basketmouth? Never.
Afraid not.
Never. You never heard of a comedian called Basketmouth? He's the biggest comedian in Africa. You've never heard of him?
No.
You've never heard of him? Wow. Nobody seems to know me. Yo, dude, excuse me. Hi. Have you heard of a comedian called Basketmouth? No? Damn.
Called Basketmouth. Basketmouth.
No.
Never.
No.
Wow. Do you know any African musician or comedian? You don't know anyone?
Mungo. Not often, no.
I'm happy you don't know any other one. Have you heard of Basketmouth before?
Never.
Wow.
His name is Basketmouth, and is the.
I'm big in Africa. We're praying.
This is the most outstanding stand-up comedian we have in Nigeria, in Africa.
It ends there.
No, it doesn't end. This guy's
one of my bestest bits ever. One of the bestest footballers ever seen from Nigeria. JJ
Okocha. Because you support Bolton. That's all, no other reason. If you are a Manchester United fan, you won't say that.
I'll Google you.
Yeah.
It's a great game.
You want to check it out?
Check it out on your Google. Basketmouth.
See, it came out by itself. Basketmouth.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
So, you want to search? Basketmouth, you see? A new African music market basketball advert for Uncensored at Houston, USA. You see him? Same guy you saw here.
Yeah, we'll check it out. Thank you.
Alright, I would have been depressed, I would have been like heartbroken if any of the guys I asked about knowing me knew other people and didn't know me. But I asked them about Two-Face, P-Square, they didn't know anybody, nobody. So I'm really excited, which means all of us for Nigeria, all of us never did popular yet. So we did the same level. All those ones, P-Square, they jump up and down. Oh, we sold out 100,000. Show story. They don't know you here. Oh. They don't know you here. So we did the same level. Even the band itself. We just say he come UK. They sign up. Can you wear sign up? They don't know. But trust me, before the end of this trip, they will know me. Check it out. You see. Man, I need to work hard. Actually, I just realized that I've not really done anything. Not done anything. Like I've not really, you know, broken that ground, that my drive is I want to take Nigerian comedy, I want to take my comedy, I want to take it outside. I want people to know that Nigeria is blessed with talent. And so far, so good. Apparently, I've only covered Africa, but I've not done shit beyond Africa. Need to push this thing further. Okay, let's go. No worry. This interview, we'll do it again. Next 1 year, we'll ask some other white people. You see, they will know me by the grace of God. Trust me.
Yeah, okay, this is my orange juice that I normally drink when we perform. It's for the cold. I don't take alcohol normally. It's for the cold.
Yeah, it's really cold.
It's really cold, trust really cold. Me. We're live in Birmingham. It's happening live. I'm so excited. And the show starts in about like 5 hours.
To be honest, no.
Very well, my name is Bryce. I want to ask you, have you ever heard of a comedian called Basketball?
No.
No. Yeah, I get to hustle.
I don't like using one perfume because I hate when people go like, that's a Tom Ford, right? I hate it. So they mix them up, meaning I'm confused. This is the second one. Yeah. Fourth one. Person who sniffed that. What are you wearing? It's none of your business. Okay. I display my dreadlock as well. It's part of my juju. Well, we're ready. Let's go.
Fuck, son. Fuck, son.
Hi, man. Sorry for keeping you waiting, man. I'm famous. That's what we do. We keep people waiting. I'm just joking. I'm sorry, man. Thank you, man.
You're welcome, sir.
Time.
Time for some action.
All right, I'm about to go on stage right now. It's time, Birmingham. That's how we do it, your boy. I'm ready. Basketball was here about 4 or 5 years ago.
And he keeps giving us something new, something different.
The jokes were fantastic. Lots of fresh stuff.
He's getting better by the day.
Oh, he's fantastic.
Obviously, if you're coming all the way up here for this show, that means you believe in it, isn't it? So yeah, we're coming here, we're showing love. So it was quite fun.
I did not regret it. So
It's lovely. It's lovely. I really enjoy my time.
He engaged the audience. He gets everybody involved, which is very good.
Very outstanding performer. And
I think it's funny. It's really funny. That's awesome. It's really great. Really nice. We really enjoyed it.
Ah, it was so funny. I loved it.
I'm quite happy about it. I think Basketmouth delivered 1 hour, 50 minutes of good content. No mistakes, no errors. You know, I give it to him. I respect him a lot. I actually appreciate him. I love you, Basketmouth.
I look forward to seeing more of this kind of shows to ease our tensions, reduce our blood pressures, make us unwind, and let us forget all our problems. At least laugh it off.
The next show we're doing is Sheila, my new movie. And then for Basketmouth, we're doing a December show, Basketmouth and Friends Musical. Then you'll see Basketmouth and Anna Element, something you've not seen before.
Birmingham was the shit. I'm sorry, excuse my language. Oh, I loved it, the crowd. Oh, the crowd, very energetic, it was electric, it was beautiful. You know, and this time around, I had fun. Honestly, I really had fun. What I'm going to be doing in London is I'm just going to perfect what I did in Manchester, what I did in Aberdeen, and what I did here in Birmingham. I'm going to just make it better. You know, I'm just, you know, going to work hard on this. This is what's up. This is what I do for a living. I love it.
Basketmouth is bride of the time, the man that I'm married to, and the father of my children.
I know him as the face of comedy in Nigeria.
The pace setter, the comedian. Someone who actually dictates the pace of comedy in this industry, like when it comes to Nigerian comedy.
The Basketman you know on stage is different from the Basketman you meet on the street. And it's different from the Basketman we grew up with.
He could be strict. He loves food and he's a very good cook.
The way he likes eating Nkobi and the seal is very fun.
He works too hard, like he puts that extra time to achieve what he wants.
I mean, very, very hardworking. He doesn't sit back and be like, okay, I've got every moment is racking his brain and he's looking on how to even enhance or make the last joke that tore up the place more better, how to deliver it.
He's always optimistic. He will say, we're going to get this, we're going to do this, no matter how difficult. He will always tell you that we're going to get it and we're going to get it done. And at the end of the day, you will see everything in black and white and we're going to get it done.
Basketmouth, Mr. Bright Okocha, is a very good comedian. It's one of the best things that ever happened to Nigerian. He's done a lot for the country and he brought comedy aspect of the country for people to know more about Nigeria apart from oil and every other thing. So
he's a gentleman that everybody knows. Some people that doesn't know him might think he's an artist, but for all I know, he is just being himself.
Knowing him as a person, he's a very kind person. He's someone that always there for people and someone that is always there to help others. Not someone that wants to eat alone, if that's right to say. But he's a very good guy. He's a very good guy. And you know, for the show, he's been doing in UK and everything, try to be other comedians from Nigeria. You know, some people wouldn't want to do that, but then again, that shows it kind of the caliber of the man.
Personally, I should say that I'm not expecting anything less than what he has given to Africa, given to UK, and the tour has been tremendous. If I have the opportunity of changing one thing about Basketmouth is
the dance, the recent dance. It throws me away. The recent dance, the one with what do you call it? Oretta Brothers, thank you very much. That dance, man, I want to change it. It's not, I don't want to, man, I don't want to use it this night, man, because it will, the dance will throw me off the stage, man.
I want him to remain as he is.
I wouldn't change anything, rather I would add something just to encourage him to do more as what he's doing, just to make the comedy in Nigeria much, much better.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome. My name is Fumi Ogunja, reporting to you live from the Basketmouth Uncensored show in the Indigo O2 London for Cocoa Bar, of course. Now, tonight, Basketmouth does this show every year, and tonight is no different from any other night. It's fully sold out. It's a sold out show, and this year has been different. It's been bigger and it's been better. Basketmouth has taken the show on the road. He's done Manchester, he's done Birmingham, and the last stop is today, London. Now, as usual, we're going to give you behind the scenes, we're going to give you in front of the stage, we're going to catch up with Basketmouth, with everybody that will be performing on the stage tonight. You do not want to miss all the exclusives we have for you today. So stay tuned and keep it locked, and I'll be catching up with you later as I pop inside and see what's happening.
Judgment night right now. I'm going in. It's time for some action.
Hey guys, I'm back, and you know me, I love being around stylish women. Like, that's part of the reason why I enjoy this show, because everyone just makes the effort and look great. You guys look great. What's your name?
Thank you, Kaney.
And Annie.
Now, you guys obviously big Basketmouth fans.
Yeah.
Is this your first time at one of these shows?
No, I was here last year.
And how was last year?
It was brilliant. I loved it.
What is it that you love about Basketmouth that's funny about?
He just sticks to his roots, you know, like he doesn't try to be like any other comedian. He just sticks to his roots, and that's what I love about him.
And today's show is Basketmouth Uncensored, so it means expect the unexpected. What are you expecting tonight?
Serious laughter, like no holding back, you know.
I like all his jokes. All his jokes are so funny and so nice. So today I just thought, oh, it would be very nice to come to his live show and then witness it for myself. So
you're in the mood to laugh?
I'm so in the mood to laugh. It's
you're
also such
laugh
a good
day.
Yeah, I know. I've been preparing for it.
But you know, today is uncensored. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. It's all going out.
It's all going. Expect the unexpected.
Wow. Wow.
You girls, like, you laugh out loud, you're not stush like.
No. I said, I'll be crying.
I'm gonna come out and see. I'm gonna come out and see that.
This is the first show that is ever sold out
100%.
100%. There's no tickets.
Since
we've been doing shows. Since we've been doing shows here, not just comedy.
Music,
everything. Wow. But I'm telling you.
Wow. Did you hear that? Yeah. Get that. Oh. Did you hear that?
First time, no joke. First time sold out. The man, trust me, crazy.
God is good, eh?
So next year, you know,
we'll go to
the big one. It's the big one.
Hey guys, I'm actually live on stage right now with Bucci. How are you doing?
I'm good.
How is the show going so far?
Well, great. Great response is 100% on point. We're happy.
Just before we started rolling, he was laughing his ass off right now to Basketmouth. Tell me, it's a sold out show. Why do you think people love Basketmouth so much?
Well, because of the work he has put in, and he's been there for a while and he's been consistent, you know. So those who have been following him have had no cause to be like, no, he's been consistent. So when you give that kind of commitment at that level, you must get 100% response, and that's what you get. So much love and support, London. This is wow.
All right, time to walk. Guys, now I know you guys will be wondering, does he really write his jokes? Yes, I do. I put everything down on a piece of paper. Sometimes I freestyle, but this kind of show, you can't do freestyling. You have to really come up with a set, a proper set, planned out, or like 100% planned out. You don't mess around. Because you only have one strike, one shot, and you have to get it right. So I have to get this right.
I'm trying to paint a picture for everybody at home, like what they're missing. Like, kind of tell us what the atmosphere is like.
You've seen the shows, you've seen the, you've gone online, you've seen YouTube, you've seen the videos, you've seen the whole the adverts and how Basketmouth has already made this an epic event. All you have to do is be here. And if you're not here, you don't know what you're missing, but I'm sure you're going to play something for them to watch.
Yeah. See, I like that word you use, epic. I think that's a very good word to describe. It's going to be epic night. He's got Basketmouth has got some surprises up his sleeve tonight, so.
I mean, you can't put anything past this guy. Yeah. Every time he comes here, he literally puts the benchmark a bit further.
Yeah.
So this time, probably going to have a helicopter coming down or something crazy for his intro.
Special
and
effects.
One of those ones there. So it's going to be crazy, and obviously I'm happy. I got my all access, so I'm going to be all over the place. But you guys, Stay tuned and stay locked. This is beautiful.
I'm going to try and catch up with Napstar later so he can give us a summary of today's show.
It's definitely. Going to get my honest opinion about the show. If there's one tear coming out of this eye doesn't work. This tear coming out of this eye. You know what's funny?
What is it about Basketmouth and why does he attract such a huge crowd?
See, a lot of people don't realize Basketmouth wins easily 300,000 fans every month. On social network, in real life, there's at least, I think most of his fans haven't seen him.
Yeah.
A lot of them realize this. He thinks he's everywhere. He's on, they see his stuff everywhere. But a lot of his fans haven't seen him. He's got so many fans that I think he's about the only one that, I think he don't realize, he's really underestimated in my opinion. Although he's the one on top, everyone sees him, but you don't quite realize how far he's traveled. Everybody came to see Basketmouth and he delivered the goods.
You need to put your hands together, land and all to make noise for Africa's finest, the king of the song.
Out of 10, what would you give the show?
10, really. It was really good.
Yeah, 10. Yeah. I laughed my ass off.
Like, and for all the people that missed it, like, what did they miss?
Everything. Ella, they missed a lot, yeah.
They missed a lot, really.
And did Basketmouth like have you laughing out loud, or are you the kind of girls that just giggle?
No, I really, really did laugh out loud. Yeah.
How did you guys enjoy the show tonight?
It was really good. Basketmouth is funny as always, like, so I enjoyed it.
It was amazing. The laughs didn't stop for 2 hours non-stop. It was great, yeah.
I love this, man. I would love it so much. Basketmouth is so much fun.
Out of 10, how much would you give the show? Out of 10.
Oh man, I would give you 11.
It was phenomenal. It was really great.
What you expected?
I was expecting fun. I had more than fun. And I mean, I've been to Basketmouth show before, and I'll say this is the best.
The best.
It was great. I can't compare it to any other comedy show that I've been to.
Basketmouth Uncensored, I mean, it's been a long journey. We've been working with Basketmouth for a number of years.
From the time, Basketmouth was very clear, Robbo was very clear for what they wanted for the campaign, in terms of how it's projected and what people see, in terms of the jokes. Everything was planned, the marketing campaign for the TV, for radio, for the street.
And this one was a new concept because he was working more or less alone.
No flavor, no two-face, no the band, no Wanderkow, just Basketmouth 100%. And we got a full house, the energy was on point, the support was massive. London, UK O2 sold out. It was really huge, it was mind-blowing, you know.
I loved it. Like, I'm very critical of Nigerian shows, just generally, movies, you know, music, comedy, anything, because I think Nigerians can do better. And so I came here tonight thinking, what's gonna happen? And I got here and I was pleasantly surprised. It started on time, the show went well, the format did well, Mike Remu was great, and Basketmouth like pulled it out of the bag. Like the comedy, the humor, the jokes were on point.
The jokes were fresh.
I think he's done so well, and
the way he executed it, we had so much energy. So I mean, that's with the timing of the DJ, it was absolutely fantastic. He knocked this one out of the park.
Anyone that thinks Basketmouth as he's no longer Basketmouth, you just you don't know that much.
I think now he's definitely told his critiques that he's in the game, and I'm so glad. Kokoba's done well. This is a good show, and Nigeria is now back on for good events, so it should get better from now.
And Basketmouth came back with a bang. He really gave a fantastic show, and he showed everybody that he's the king of comedy.
He's now the real Basketmouth. He's the beast. He's a guru guru. He's a guru guru one. From the east. Beast from the east.
Basketmouth was very, very dedicated from the beginning. He flew, I couldn't count how many times he flew into London.
He's a planner, and he doesn't play around with his brand. He likes things to be done in a certain way and for the team to deliver things in a certain way. And he's a perfectionist, and that shows in how he delivers his work.
It was great working with him and the whole team.
So yeah, it's great working with him. I actually like working with people who know what they want and how they want things to be.
If someone has left his place feeling like he hasn't gotten value, then that person must be a cheat.
I'm telling you, for the record, when I said no show has actually ever sold out at Indigo, trust me, everybody was, everywhere was packed, it was sold out, people were standing at the back, it was crazy. So big up to Basketmouth, he did it again, and this time around he did it by himself, only him on the show. It's never been done before, absolutely killed it, and people actually came out to see Basketmouth, they have fun, it was crazy. Big up Basketmouth, big up Coco Bar, Phoenix Media of course, the whole team, I saw films, everybody, man. It's been a long journey. February, three cities, killed the UK, and next year of course we're going bigger. Expect magic on time.
Exactly, we're doing the Hammersmith next year.
Okay.
Yeah, it's booked already, and it's on Valentine's Day in London, so you'll have that sort of a Valentine effect. Tickets are going on sale next month. In terms of we're doing Birmingham, I think Birmingham's Friday, and then Manchester is Sunday.
Ladies and gentlemen, we've come to the end of an amazing show. Congratulations, Basketmouth.
Thank you very much.
How was it for you?
I'm happy, right? I'm so happy. I'm overwhelmed. I'm excited, trust me.
I actually need to congratulate you three times because Manchester, Birmingham all sold out.
Yeah.
And, you know, amazing responses.
Yeah, people loved it and I'm just happy. And first of all, I have to thank God for the talent and for the, you know, God has been partial with me actually, I have to say that. You know, and you know, for all the guys, or everyone that came out, you guys actually made it happen. It's just not just me, you guys actually made it happen, because for me, comedy is a trade. I give you guys the jokes, you guys give me the laughter, and the laughter, trust me, it's my strength and it keeps me going, and you guys really, really made it happen. Thank you very much, and you know, I can't see.
We look forward to a bigger and better show.
Yeah, we already, Rocco just told me that we're doing the Hammersmith Apollo on the 14th of February 2015. It's already booked, tickets are going to start selling very soon. Everyone is excited, and you know, I'm excited. You know, I have to start writing more materials, you know, fresh materials, you know. It's hard, yeah.
Thank you very, very much.
Thank you very much, Kokoba, you guys are on point. Thank you very much, Rocco, Tunde, Phoenix, Abby, everyone, you. Thank you very much, I love you guys.
Thank you.
Pay me.